Good afternoon, everyone. We welcome all the first year BDS students to today's session. I am Priyanka Jain from the marketing team of Elsevier, and I'll be moderating the session today with my colleague Kritika Monga. We hope the session will help you understand the right approach to prepare for your exams. But before we start the session, I would like to convey that all of you are kept on mute and there is no option to unmute yourself. So if you have any question, then please write it in the Q&A tab. It is seen at the bottom panel of your screen. If you are connected through a mobile, then it will be on the top of the screen. So please post all the questions and all the queries that you have only in the Q&A tab. At the end of the presentation, Dr. Rao will answer those questions. With this, let me now introduce to you our speaker of the day, Dr. Jyotsna Rao. Dr. Rao is a senior faculty and founder director of SRS Dental Exams Academy, Bengaluru. Earlier, she was a professor in the Department of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery, the Oxford Dental College Hospital and Research Center in Bangalore. She has done her BDS and MDS from Government Dental College and Hospital, Hyderabad. She has completed her PG diploma in oral implantology from Manipal Academy of Higher Education, and she obtained the fellowship in oral implantology from Indian Society of Oral Implantology. Dr. Rao has immense experience in teaching UG and PG students. She also keeps herself actively involved in exploring innovative and practical ways of teaching the budding professionals for various state and national level postgraduate entrance examinations. So with this, I hand it over to Dr. Rao to take on the today's session for you. Welcome, Dr. Rao, over to you.
Thank you, Priyanka, for your kind words of introduction. And I welcome all the viewers to this session, and especially the first BDS candidates for whom this session is conducted. And good evening, everybody. I mean, we'll start with the exam preparatory tips for the first BDS students. How exactly the first BDS differs from your school and colleges? All these years, you were just from the school students and you have just entered from your intermediate or like higher secondary schools to the professional course. There is a lot of difference between the school environment and the professional environment. Now you're elated, you're doctors, like the first day with the white coat in your, this thing, with aprons, you're entering the class of anatomy, the dissection hall. It gives you a elated feeling. Yes, it's a very good spirit, like you have attained, I mean, like you have achieved or conquered your goal of becoming a doctor. That's great. Like the feeling of becoming a doctor gives you a kick, the same kick you should carry throughout your career as a student to absorb and grasp the subject in a proper way, so that it will be helpful to the patients throughout your life, whomever you are treating. So this is the first step as a professional in your life. So the professional studies are something different from the school and college studies, because there the main goal is study, write an exam, get your grades, marks, enjoy, just forget. So this is not like that. It is the subject which carries with you for your lifetime. This exam is only a nominal, what do you say, a criteria for the student to pass from year to year. So this is the first professional exam you're going to appear, is a first BDS exam. As you're a dental student, the first exam in your life as a professional you're going to take now. So how it differs, like whatever, like once you enter the college, and no one knows, like including me also, like first year is just something good feel, it carries on for some time. After that, we start feeling, oh, what is this subjects, enormous subjects, how to read so much and how to write an exam. So exam, the feel of exam itself will create some fear in us, but there is nothing, like it is just like, it's a crucial step in every student's life. But only thing is, I mean, like it is a device which measures your knowledge, or like it measures your capability to just pass on to the next year. So there is nothing to so much worry about it. Only when you fail exams, people keep saying it's a bad luck, bad time and all. Nothing like that. Examinations are like, with a good preparation, they are nothing. They are daily routine. It's one part of your curriculum. So how about we have to go with the first BDS subjects and the exams. So let us carry on. In the first BDS, the first subject is a general anatomy, including embryology and histology. So as a part, from the start part of, I mean, like the, from the development starting itself, the embryology deals with the development of the human being from the egg and zygote stage. Okay, from that stage also you are reading or you are learning, because even from there also the two development also passes hand in hand. So that is also included in the curriculum for that reason. So embryology, histology for studying the sectional views and like to identify the sections of the different parts of body and all, it helps you. So this is a normal human structures you will be studying in this histology. But when it comes to the next years, where you have to read the diseases, then you will understand what is normal, what is abnormal. So that is the reason we'll study the general normal human histology in the first year. So all these basic subjects carry with us to give the knowledge. So you keep applying in coming years. So it will be helpful to apply this knowledge and study till final year. So this carries with you till lifelong, but of course for exams till final year you remember all this subject with you. So anatomy including embryology, histology is a one subject, and the next subject is a physiology, biochemistry. There are two different subjects, but we appear for exam as a physiology and biochemistry, because there is an application of the total body. Human physiology is important to understand whatever you treat in the head and neck region. So that is how physiology comes into the way, and biochemistry also, the nutritional levels of the patients and all those things we have to know. So for that reason, what is that is the importance of the biochemistry. So nutrition, I mean like all the metabolisms in the body, carbohydrate, lipid, I mean like protein metabolisms, how they affect the other parts of the treatment in the oral cavity also, it's like there is an application. So that is the reason these subjects are taught in the very, very first year. And next is the oral histology and dental anatomy. This is a prime subject. As a general anatomy, particularly restricted to the head and neck, is a oral histology and dental anatomy. We have to know that in thorough, so that when you do the procedures and all those things, we'll have a knowledge of it. And when you read the oral histology, you understand how the enamel, dentin, cementum, all those things differ, and what are the various differences in their formation or like any abnormalities. Everything you have to study with this knowledge. So general anatomy, and then oral histology, oral anatomy, physiology, biochemistry. These are the subjects which are dealt in the first year. All are very good, nice, lively subjects. We start loving the subjects. Once you start reading, you'll be really carried away. You'll be keep reading only. Like they are not dry as the next coming second year subjects. So these are very interesting and very nice subjects to read. So however nice, however interesting, all those things to understand for the first half of the year, you can contribute good time to read all the textbooks, all the available material regarding the all four subjects. But when it comes to exam preparation, you have to have a systematic plan. So proper plan for preparation and procuring the syllabus, how much syllabus is included for the dental students, that also is important. What is the dental application of it is, they'll be dealing it most commonly. So when you read them, so what is the syllabus allotted for dental students, we have to know for that. And knowing the pattern of the question papers, so how the questions will be categorized, how they ask the questions, and all these things are very, very important. So question pattern is very important to know, the like attempting the answers. So choosing the correct books and the study materials, so proper books in the sense, in the beginning of the year you have to choose the good textbooks. As it comes to the later period, like as you approach, start coming nearer to the exams, it is a quick review books and the study materials what we write in the class. So written study material or any available quick review series, all these are the good books in the last period of the preparation. So these are the steps in exam preparation. Next comes proper planning of the exam preparation, time planning, choosing perfect subjects as per the time schedule, and some common textbooks to be used, quick revision materials, and practical exam preparation. Exam always, it is complete with theory and the practical. Put together, you are assessed as a passed or failed. So passing theory is equally important as to pass the practical exam. So these two sections you have to keep in the mind when you are preparing for the exams. So time planning. Time planning is really very, very essential. How much time you can contribute to each subject, you should have an idea. And choosing a perfect subject means, like you start with some physiology, biochemistry, interestingly, you keep reading them. So the time gets just passed away like that. So you should not waste the time like that. You choose a proper subject. Among these three subjects, very legible and concise is the dental anatomy and the oral histology. So you can just finish off that at a fast pace. You can finish that, you can finish off the anatomy, so that both of them Each subject carries 70-70 marks, whereas when it comes to the physiology biochemistry, each subject carries only 35 marks, or if it is a paper is for 100 marks, it carries 50-50 marks. So that means both subjects put together, how much time you contribute is same as the one subject as of the human anatomy or dental anatomy. So that is how choosing subject differs per the, as per the time schedule. In the available time, you contribute equally for the three papers. There are four subjects, but three papers. So keeping that in the view, you have to frame, schedule your time. So common textbooks, Gray's Anatomy, I mean like Orban's Oral Histology, and then like Harper's Biochemistry. There are so many good books, Guyton and Ganong Physiology. There are lot number of books, but nowadays as the teachers are like directing to do different books and all those things as per your local demand and like your senior suggestions, you will be going with whatever book you like. But whichever book you choose a good standard textbook in the beginning of the year. That's very, very essential to understand the subject to the depth. So common textbooks you have to choose, and then quick revision materials. At the end of the exams, you have to go for the revision material. So quick review series is one of that kind of the book. It will help you frame the answers. I'm like, it is having the framed answers. So you have to only just put those answers onto the exam. So it is very, very easy. Like it is a ready-made noodles, which is given in your hands, like that book is. So there is no need for you to frame the questions. I mean, like answers for the questions. So to frame an answer itself, you take a lot of time. So to avoid that, this helps you to give you the ready-made answers. In case if something is missing, you can pick up from your common textbooks and add up there with a pencil note or whatever it is. And practical exam preparation. So this is all theory exam, time planning, choosing subjects, common textbooks, quick revision of the material. As hand in hand, when you're preparing this practical exam also, you have to keep in your mind. So make a small note of all the things which are important from the practical exam point of view. Maintain a small notebook for that, so that it will be helpful in the ending of your preparation. So time planning, time is really very, very essential. Though we have interest, though you want to gain knowledge, but time is limited. Because if there is no time bond, nobody will like complete the subject any day. You keep on reading Gray's Anatomy for next 1 year and 2 years also. It will be so lovely book to read. But it's okay, fine. For the gaining knowledge, you can attribute the time. But for the exam preparation, the time is limited. So in case of the leisure preparation, you allot about 3 months of your time. So that three subjects, that is three papers you are going to write. That is your anatomy, your dental anatomy, human physiology, biochemistry. Make it into those three parts, three sections. Give 3 months time. So leisurely, daily, three topics, all subjects put together. If you complete also, you can leisurely read a good textbook of your choice. In case of the quick preparation, say, okay, fine, all the time is over. You are left with last 10-15 days. Catch QRS, it will just help you just scan through the subject. Like it will help you to just revise the whatever knowledge you have put in the format of the question papers. Because here not only question papers, if you get back to the back of the book, you have a nice question bank. First thoroughly read the question bank so that you'll get an idea which chapters have got the weightage, from where the long essays are pointed out, from where the short essays are asked, short notes where they are actually touching which type of topics. So like that you can sit, and like in 9 to 10 topics per day, if you finish off, it's awesome. Like your preparation is complete. It gives you a feel like you are totally prepared for exam. So that is the last minute, what I say. It is like QRS is not a replacement for any textbooks, but it is a good supplement to all the textbooks. See, when you write a prescription, we'll write the major antibiotic and the required medicines, and followed by that always one supplement, one B complex, one vitamin C, something like that we add up for the fast recovery or the good immune backup. So like that, QRS is a capsule of the vitamin. And time schedule, as I told you, three subjects, 3 months. Three subjects in the sense, always see physiology, biochemistry as together. Then it is three subjects only. General anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, oral histology, dental anatomy. They are also two parts, but the total entire is a one subject. So this is how 3 months, three subjects is a simple rule for the first year. And I'm telling you, this is really very, very leisure preparation. Later onwards, as you enter the clinics, you don't even get the time. Maybe like first 3 years will be very nice. You'll have three, four subjects per year. But when it comes to final year, you have totally eight subjects. Or if community is there, it'll be like nine subjects also are included. So eight papers when somebody writes, you should understand the tension, the amount of the stress you have to undergo. Here I'm telling daily and like 3 months time, if you have one subject you take per month also you can finish. Where is that leisure preparation in the final year? So you don't think of that and get panic, but this is a good thing. Like you make a habit like this so that later you can mix and match. When you know all the subjects, the application in the coming years will be very, very nice and it'll be simple. The subjects you can understand very easily. Choosing subjects, I already discussed with you. Choice among the subjects is yours, whether you finish general anatomy, dental anatomy, and come back to human physiology and the biochemistry, or you can finish off oral anatomy and the oral histology because it's a very nice subject. Simple subjects, you can just read it in 10 days, I'll tell you. Even the nice common textbook, Orban's also, happily you can read Wheeler's anatomy, Orban's if you take. Whatever is required, you make a note. It will be very simple to complete that book. It's an awesome book. Finish of that, you'll get a good feel. Okay, one subject is finished for the preparation. So next, get on to the human anatomy. Interesting, lovely subject. Pick up how much is required for you for the exam point of view. And then topics with weightage are the important questions, what you have to know. That's the reason I told you. You read good common textbooks throughout the year, gain some knowledge. And when it comes to exams, you catch the right books, take a right path, because right path always leads towards success. So take the right book. QRS series has got a good question bank at the end. Go through the question bank just for about 10 minutes, 15 minutes. You concentrate on that. You'll gain some knowledge like what type of questions are asked and which topics are most concentrated for the long essays, short essays and all those things. So just to gain that knowledge, first you look at the question bank. Number of years, how many times it is asked also, we have put it near wise by the side and universities also are mentioned. So you can just see like what are the topics which are mainly aimed at long essays, which are the topics which are aimed towards the short notes, because very, very, I mean, like latest topics or like less important topics, like those things will be added for the short notes. Whereas important things always will be touched in the long essays. So not even long essay, when you're preparing for long essay, by the side, you are preparing in itself for the short essays and short notes also. Okay, so when it comes to the general anatomy, the topics, every topic is important. I am not asking you to leave any of these topics. This is all concised and given a small table of contents in QRS. So this is like how you have to go about with the preparation. See, all weightage chapters, we have just marked it with the red blocks. It shows you osteology of the head and neck. It's very, very important from both the viva and the practical point of view, plus theoretical point of view, how many bones they are asked in the exams and cervical vertebrae, various bones, all those things you should have a good knowledge, all the foramina, contents of the foramina, all these things are collectively there in the osteology. So head and neck bones, osteology of the head and neck is very, very important from both the points of view. And then scalp, temple, face, that is a, I mean like regular topic, side of the neck, cranial cavity, what are the structures in the cranial cavity and like what are the contents, what are the nerves, how they pass, how the blood vessels enter the cranium, all those things are very important and how the sinuses are designed. So all these things in the cranial cavity. And coming to the anterior triangle of the neck, parotid region, temporal, infratemporal region, submandibular, and then deep structures of neck, all these are very, very important topics with always some long essays asked from them. Mouth, pharynx, nose, paranasal sinuses, larynx, tongue, all these are dental related, plus equally anatomy. And so all these things are the first priority choice topics to finish off. First finish off them, 80% of your preparation is finished. So next come to the back of the neck, contents of vertebral column, orbit, because even orbital muscles and all those things also sometimes asked as a long essay. So don't leave them, but study them, but in the next order. So prevertebral region, eyeball, ears, regional anatomy, brain and all those things equally important. But to gain the marks, this block subjects are like these block topics will help you to gain more marks. That's all. And general histology, totally it is essential. General histology, all short essay questions can be expected and short notes questions can be expected from the histology part of it. And then pharyngeal arches, face, nose and palate and the defects in the formation of these things are always one long essay question you can expect from the embryology section. Or otherwise short essay is a common from them. So this is how weightage of the topics will go in the subject. So first choosing the subjects, I mean like how you want to choose and like how you want to conserve the time. Next coming on to choosing the topics within the subject, because this is how the preparation, if you lessen your burden, I'm like you give more, I mean like you are working hard, but you have to output should also be equally good. So for that reason, you concentrate in this order, it will really help you to gain the good marks. So exam is marks gaining. Exam main criteria is gaining of marks. So this is a one formula, that's all. It will work for everybody, but it is a choice. It's not a random rule like you have to follow like this only. This is not a thumb rule, but this is like a guidance. And same thing with the physiology. When you come to the physiology, the major topics are cardiovascular system, blood, respiration, digestive system, and all the glands, endocrine glands, reproductive system, nervous system. These are the systems which are mainly touched for the long essays. So first finish off those things. So you'll be done with good half of the topics will be happily covered and you'll be confident enough to answer any short essay, short notes, long essay also. And by this side, once you've finished with this, come on to the excretory system and vitamin metabolism, types of tissue, cell structure. All these things are touched for the short notes and the short essays. So equally, they are very important topics. So first give the weightage to these topics and later come to the rest of the topics. And biochemistry. In the same way, when you come to biochemistry, carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, without that, there is no biochemistry. And everything like chemistry of the carbohydrates, chemistry of the proteins, lipids, along with their metabolisms. So chemistry and metabolism of each of these components, carbohydrates, proteins, lipids is equally important. And inorganic substances like calcium and all those things. And then biological oxidation, all this, they are questions, but little lesser weightage. And water electrolyte balance, enzymes, these are all good, like they are covered in a vast extent, and vitamins. First complete of this and then go on to the hemoglobin, urine, organ function test, hormones, nutrition, diet, all these things you can cover in the later section. So this will help you to attain good marks. And these are the important topics which you don't dare to leave it when you're preparing this particular subject. And next comes the oral histology and anatomy. Oral histology, anatomy, each and every topic is important as a dental surgeon. But in that also from the exam point of view, you start going with the development of the face and then development and growth of the teeth, enamel, dentin, cementum, pulp, periodontal ligament, all these are essential things you have to learn. It is very, very essential both from the point of view of exams as well as tomorrow when you're working in the clinics also, this will help you a lot. And then oral mucous membrane, salivary gland functions, all those things are very, very important. And followed by that, temporomandibular joint, sinus, and then shedding of deciduous teeth, how they erupt, how they shed, everything. And the bone, which is supporting structure for the teeth. The anatomy of it is equally important to know. And so this is how you go along. And so this 7 topics you finish off in the first go, and then not only that, all these 10 topics, like they are very important. After that, you can come on to the less important topics so that exam point of view, you can gain good marks. And then dental anatomy, of course, you have to know the numbering system and the general physiology of the oral, oral facial complex form, function, physiology. There commonly you have to know. And in spite of it, every tooth in detail, like the permanent and the deciduous, both the differences in the morphology you have to remember, because all this will come into application when you enter the clinicals. When you enter the pediatric clinics, you have to know the anatomy of the pediatric teeth, what procedures you do on them, like what are applicable to those teeth. And when you come to the conservative endodontics department, this particular morphology of the teeth will help you how to make the cavities and how to make an access preparation for the root canals and all. So if you remember a little now, it will be very helpful to brush up at that time so that you can be good endodontist or like good root canal doctors. So this is how the application will be. And also, you know how the infection spreads in them. So which teeth has got the more proneness to them. So thickness of the bone around each tooth, all those things, the morphology, the shape of the teeth, and the defects, what are common in the different teeth, all these things. I mean, like developmental defects will be more common in certain teeth, like your lateral incisors and your third molars and all those things. So what procedures you have to avoid in them, or what procedures are required in them, both are equally important. So this is how the application will be. But now when we are reading, we don't know application because it is a subject we are reading. So not like that. Read with an inclination towards its application in the coming years also, not only exams. So from exams point of view, all this anatomies. And whereas from the application point of view, everything you remember as much as possible. So this is about the oral histology anatomy, important topics. So this way, when you start preparing with the, weightage topics, marks gaining is very easy. You can gain as much. If you aim at least 90%, 80%, definitely you will gain. Like that, the preparation goes on. And this is fine. Like we have given the importance to the subject, later the topics, and all these things are over. Your preparation is almost complete. You're done. Will it give the full feel like, okay, I'm ready? No, what they'll ask in Viva, what again they'll, what will be first things they cover in the exam? This will be keep on popping up in your minds. So for that reason, few things, you make a list of it. You try to memorize them as many times as possible. See layers of the scalp, and then your skull bones, arteries, veins, nerves, and then triangles of neck, muscles of mastication, tongue, or the muscles and its supply, all those things you keep on memorizing, so that they're the most common things which they will be asking in Viva also. And these are the revision topics. These are repeatedly, you have to memorize them. And when it comes to the physiology, all the numerical values of the blood components and whatever, hemoglobin levels, and then serum creatinine, all these things. Lot of things are there. So all the components of the blood, CBP, the complete blood picture, what all it covers there. So all these things you can know, bleeding time, clotting time, prothrombin time, all these are very, very essential. Now, if you have the knowledge, when you come to the pathology, it will be very useful there. So all these blood components, red blood cells, white blood cell counts, and the differential counts, all these things you have to have a little memorizing this thing. Attitude. Otherwise, they are all fixed numbers, fixed numerical values, which are to be only recited and remembered. And then cardiac cycle is important to remember. Then the enzymes of digestive system, vitamins, hormones, and then other biological values. And then carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, and all these things are very, very important to memorize. So these are the things in the physiology, biochemistry, you have to do a repeated revision. And when it comes to the oral histology anatomy, everything starting from enamel, dentin, cementum, the different structures in it, and how they differ, what is the thickness, what are the abnormalities, everything you have to remember, because each and everything is important. And tooth numbering systems, definitely all the notations, like your universal notation, Palmer notation, FDI, everything you have to know. Though you apply whatever system is followed in your this thing, it is different. But you have to know like how they were numbered, how we are numbering them. So all the numbering systems you have to memorize. And the chronology of the primary and the permanent dentition. The chronology, like the time of eruption, time of shedding, that all these things you have to have in the mind. Because when you decide a treatment for the deciduous teeth, it should be applicable with the time of shedding also. Because for a shedding tooth, tomorrow within 1 week, 1 month, if it is going to shed, if you advise a root canal and pulpectomy and a cap for that, it is meaningless. So you can't advise some procedures when it is nearer to fall down or the shedding. So you should have an idea. Otherwise, patient himself will question you, what doctor, you don't know this much, this is going to fall. How did you do so much treatment for this? They'll ask you. So to avoid all those things, or for your better knowledge, like you should know when the permanent dentition comes. So till what time you have to maintain those deciduous teeth, or if it is shedding, you have to check with the radiograph whether the erupting permanent dentition is existing or not. When you will check, if you have an idea, like it is a time for it to come, you will get that knowledge to write one diagnostic test. So all these things are important for you to take the decisions when you're treating the patients. So you don't know now, but when you start applying it, you'll understand. morphology of the individual teeth. You will be doing carving in the dental anatomy. So all these things are important so that you feel how the tooth is, how slender or how strong or how many roots it carries, how many canals it carries. All this is important when you do the root canal treatments in the permanent teeth and when you prepare a cavity for the filling or when you want to design an aesthetic, this thing, a smile design procedure, something like that. This morphology of the teeth will help you to analyze the things properly and to have the knowledge to go in the right direction towards the treatments. So that's the importance of the morphology of the individual tooth. And then coming to the good books. What are good books? All are good books, like whatever you understand are good books. But there are certain very, very good books which are coming from the age old before I was born also. One like thing is one Grey's Anatomy. It's really superb. I mean, like if you see that book, you just get carried away. You'll be like, feel as if you're seeing a dissected cadaver in front of us. Like the figures are also so awesome in that. So such a books, what happens? You develop interest when you're reading. Okay, fine. Then Chaurasia and all those things, we can just see that. And Moni, all these things, you can happily read anatomy in a concised way. So good books are like best books. You have to choose according to the books what they follow in your universities or the colleges. But further, when you come to the physiology, biochemistry and all those things, a lot of books are there. But see which has got a very good dental application and you choose a book from that. And whereas in the oral anatomy, histology, we all know Orban's, Wheeler's, they go hand in hand. Like ages have gone, but the books still I see in the hands of the students. They're really wonderful books and very nice, simple things. You can easily complete those books. I mean, like as you look at the book itself, it'll be like welcoming you, like okay fine, you can finish off in 10-15 days, like that. It give you a feel, it's nice. Like a book, like it starts, the feel starts from the day we see the book. So common textbooks, the what are the standard books you should know and what are the legible books which we can read also, we have to decide on the part of it. That is left to each individual's choice. And then finally, whatever books you read, how much ever knowledge you gain at the end, a quick revision of the thorough knowledge of the subject is very, very essential because we can't read again the entire subjects back. So how to quickly revise them as from the examination point of view. Quick review series is one such a book. It is actually designed keeping all this in the view. What are the most commonly asked questions? In what pattern they are asking? Long or short essays or short notes pattern? So everything is kept in that manner in that. So any book like that, whichever mimics or like which, whether it is a QRS or any similar books, you can choose as per your choice. And the study material is like you make a notes. Whenever you read, you make a habit of writing few points at the end of your reading so that it makes a small notes of about 20-30 pages at the end of your preparation. So that is very good actually. It will allow you to recollect all the things what you read for your practical, viva, and just before exam, you will have a very good material with you. I mean, like it's a good boost. Like this is because you have prepared, you know what depth is one sentence you mean. So that way you make a small study material, not very big, like it is a 20-30 pages, you manage to have a study material with you. Or draw some flow charts, draw some simple diagrams wherein you can remember the subject. So quick review series along with your study material is the right choice in the ending of the preparation. At the end or just before exams, it's really awesome. The preparation will be complete. You will get that feel of completeness before you go to the exams. And I've been telling you long essay questions. So see here, the long essay can be asked in any of the formats. See, enumerate dural venous sinuses, describe the cavernous sinus in detail. And like the same question asked in different formats. Next year they have asked describe cavernous sinus and its relation, simple direct question. And next some universities and some years, like it is all a combination, different years, different university questions, they are classify dural venous sinuses, describe in detail position, contents, tributaries, applied aspect of cavernous sinus. Here they have split the question into so many sections, there is no need for you to think on it. You can just put all this as a side heads and start writing whatever you know. So that makes your complete long answer. See, when they ask the relations, here some relations are there. So each cavernous sinus, how it is, they described it. And the classification of the sinuses has been given here. There are about 23 venous sinuses. So when you make it into a small list, there are about 8 paired and 7 unpaired sinuses. It's so simple to remember here. But when you see the number 23, wow, 23 venous sinuses. But when you pair it and club it, it will be simple to remember. So like that, you manage to have the, prepared notes with you, so that this answer will be very easy for you to attempt. Here, you have classified all the venous sinuses, cavernous sinus position you have described, and then relations you have given, like that, the applications or the local aspect, applied aspect of it, the infections when they spread, how it will be dissipated to the other structures, everything you can describe. So a long answer forms around 15-20 lines or more than that. Like it should be completed within half an hour. So that you keep a target of half an hour, it takes some 40-45 minutes to complete. But the marks allotted will be 10 marks. So why I am describing so much is, you see how we have to divide the time when you come to the question paper. And next comes, see here, one short essay section of the anatomy, histology of the cartilage is a question. So when they ask for short essay, this is meant for 5 marks or 6 marks based on the university. They either give 5 marks or 6 marks to the short essay section. Here what happens, they asked about cartilage. They didn't mention anything. See, like last question, they did not ask like how many types of cartilages are there, what are the components of it, what is the content of, nothing they asked. So here you're free to describe in the way you want, but it should be in the methodical way. See, here the answer is framed in such a way, it is, what is cartilage? It's a modified connective tissue. And what are the cells it contains, what they are called. So all the structure also is described here. Then comes the matrix. The matrix, what substance it is made up of, a homogeneous ground substance, which has got some fibers, which are embedded in that and all those things. And see, nicely in each 4 lines, you have some collagen fibers mentioned there, and what the ground substance composition is mentioned here, and matrix, what is the composition is mentioned here. What is matrix? What is a ground substance? What are the components? Whether it has some cells, fibers, everything is covered in these 5 points. So to gain those 5 marks, if you put this 5 points also, they'll give you 4 marks. And in spite of it, what are the various types of cartilages you can describe? So hyaline cartilage, fibrocartilage, everything is discussed here. Whereas same histology of cartilage, same question, but the section is short notes. I think long essays, short essays, short notes. These are the 3 section categories under which your questions will be divided. So when it asked in the short notes, you can't write this much. It is a time waste. And marks allotted are 2 marks. For 2 marks, how much you want to write? Whether you write 20 pages also, you'll get 2 marks only. Whether you write 4 lines also, 2 marks, but which are relevant. So here, cartilage, it's a modified tissue. It has got some ground substance. It has got some fibers. That's all. That much is important for the short notes. What it is, if you describe thoroughly also, you'll get all the 2 marks. Or in case if you have a small extra time, 4th point also you can add, what are the various types of cartilages. That could make the 4th point. It will be an additional, definitely 2 marks are in your pocket. So this is how the comparison of the questions goes. Histology of the cartilage in short note section is answered like this, whereas in the short essay section we answered like this. So that much difference if you identify. And if it is asked for the long essay, how it will be. So that much you should know. So that is how the difference in attempting the questions in exam varies. And this is the comparison of the questions. So usually 10, 5, 2 marks. These are the marks allotted for the questions. This is one of the universities. So here you have 2 long essays and 8 short essays they asked, and 5 short notes. So 5 into 2, 10 marks, 8 into 5, 40 marks, 2 into 10, 20 marks. So based on these marks, the time is 3 hours. So 3 hours, how you have to divide among this. So first attempt of last section, 5 into 2. So 5 questions, 2, 2 marks. 5 questions, how long you take? 4 points, you write 2, 2 minutes is enough. Okay, 10 minutes at the max, 20 minutes you can spend here. So otherwise keep 1/2 an hour for this section so that you can divide for the short essays also. So 1/2 an hour you allot to the last section, finish off. You are guaranteed with 10 marks. And next 1.5 hour you concentrate for the short essays. So there are about 8 questions you have to write, and 1.5 hours you just divide your time, about 10 to 12 minutes for each question you can give, and get around 40. So 40 plus 10, 50 marks are finished within first 1.5 hour, 2 hours. First 1.5 hour itself, this will get finished. if you are really thorough with the subject. Otherwise, take 2 hours. So two sections you will be completing and you will be on the safe side to gain the marks to pass. 40 plus 10, 50 marks. Even if you attempted half of it, you'll get 25 marks. Aram se. Like, and 30 marks are there which are allotted from the college side. So 70 is a paper mark. 30%, 30 marks will be from the internal assessments and Viva. Put together, they'll be added. So there also, if you get some 10 marks, here you're getting some 25 marks. That's enough. You can pass the exam. So passing exam is not a great criteria, but gaining marks is a good logic in attempting the sections. So always start with the short notes, complete them, short essays. You can be sure of, like, you have done with the 50 marks in first 2 hours. Otherwise, if you start spending time with the long essay in the beginning, if 2 hours is gone with the two long essays, then it will be very panicky in the last minute. You can't cover all the questions. And in exam, you just remember one point, how much ever you know, you just put that onto the paper. Don't ever leave a question. If you put it onto the paper, even if you try to write one line, sometimes if that one line and one mark may help you to pass, which who are going to fail with that one mark. So best is, like, start with the short notes, then the short essays, then come back to long essays, because sometimes you'll be very enthusiastic and you'll be having a total knowledge of the long essay. But don't, I mean, like, time is short, time is limited. So you have to divide time and then you have to put it in the proper order. Good thing is, like, nowadays the questions only they are asking in the split way, so you're very easy. See, like, describe the muscles of mastication under origin, insertion, nerve supply, action, applied anatomy. Here for you there is nothing to think. You have to know all the muscles of mastication. Just put the all the muscles of mastication in one order. Each muscle you can make either a table or individually you can write origin, insertion, action and applied anatomy. Best is make one table, put a small, scenario of it in the beginning, so that if it gives the entire subject there, the examiner will be happy and you're allotted all the 9 or 10 marks at one shot, one go. If everything is correct, what you have put in the table. In case, if you're not so sure of that, then start writing individually. These are the two techniques to bully the examiner. So though I am also an examiner, I am also an evaluator, but how much ever you want to bully, we know how much you know. Okay, that's not a part of bullying, but only thing is it takes some time to go through. Otherwise, if we put in a box, chuck, they'll catch. So if you are very sure, you want to gain all the 10 marks, if you are really confident of your answer, put in a short, simple way of either a ray diagram or a flow chart or a box. It will be really attractive to gain the marks if you are really thorough with your subject. Otherwise, keep on writing in the theory. It is our patients to read your answers. So the next comes, see, parotid gland. Here also nicely they have given the sections covering surfaces and the relations, duct and applied anatomy. Good, they have given all the sections, 4 sections. So you write relevant theory of those 4 sections, you're granted 8 marks, 9 marks. Maybe if you're too good, all the 10 also, 10 we'll give, because it is categorized in the heading wise, subsections. So if you are really covering the entire thing required for the section, you are allotted the entire marks. So this way you can have your 3 hours time really with a good justice, justified for the marks allocation. So start in this manner, it will be very helpful so that you will not be in a rush at the end of the exam preparation. It will be a leisure presentation. If you really, good skills of presentation, you practice nice presentation skills first. Knowing subject, everybody will know, but putting onto the paper and presenting is also an art of the examination. So this is the same scenario. This is human anatomy paper. Here also you have 2 long essays, 8 this thing and 5. Whereas when it comes to the physiology biochemistry, the marks are divided. The same 70 marks, they have given 35 marks for each subject. There also same thing applies. But only thing is, here you want to finish off one subject first. Same rule you follow. Short notes, short essays, and then long essay. Here only 1 essay. So essay, you keep a time, half an hour. Before half an hour, I have to complete. So 20 minutes, half an hour is the time for the essay. So check, 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 you can complete it off. So half the time, 1.5 hour for the physiology, 1.5 hour for biochemistry. So here the total time, 3 hours, you split into 2 sections. Then in that section, do the justice for each category of the questions. So that is how an exam paper approach should be. And this is all about the theory exams, theory very vast preparation, good, nice, like we have come out with the real good skills for the presentation of the answers. Fine, all that is good for that. But when it comes to practical exam, you always make some key points whenever you read a topic. So that I've been stressing from the beginning, that is your small notes or preparatory material, what I call. Read some important Viva questions in the QRS. We have given Viva questions as well as some key points and also MCQs. They are more than enough. You can cover ample of questions in those three sections and three categories. So what will be Viva? Only the subject which is there in the theory only is Viva. But when we pick up, it will be question wise. Like that also you have, I've got a sample in that book. So just go through the Viva questions, key points, and multiple choice questions. They'll make up a part of your Viva. Because Viva, uska marzi, that like the examiner's will and wish, but it won't cross your subject. So that much is sure. So if you're thorough with the subject, whatever they want to ask, let them ask. You are with an answer. So that is how Viva preparation will be. So key points of each subject you read thoroughly, some important Viva questions if you can get, and some MCQs. And then remember the specimens and spotters which are shown during your practical classes. And then practice the procedures to be performed in examination. In the anatomy, dissections, you should be thorough. And whereas in the dental anatomy, carving and all those things, in physiology, biochemistry, certain few chemical tests and all, they'll give you some blood examination, clotting time, bleeding time and all those things. So you be thorough with all those things. That will be enough for the practical exam preparation. So this is practical exam. Key points, Viva questions, and then multiple choice questions, remembering all the spotters and specimens to be kept in the examinations. And they will also call you one day or 2 days before and show you the spotters one day. There will be a day of spotters. So you can just memorize from that also. And practice the procedures properly when you're posted for this particular subjects. And then after all this, we become what you do. So you become what you study is a saying by Robert Kiyosaki. It is a common saying, like we all know, what we sow you will be reaping. And the next thing is key take home points. I mean, like setting a goal in exams, what will be the goal? Passing is the goal. Or maybe if you are excellent, some gaining of some medals or like getting some distinctions and all those things can also be the goals. So goal varies individually. So it is a choice of individual to set your own goal. Then systematic skimming of the topics. I told you it is not the simple like put one book in front of you, start reading, start from the A, complete at the Z. Not like that. In that A to Z, which is more important, give the stress on that. So make a list of the topics, make important topics list separately, and thoroughly you read each topic according to the weightage. And then associated reading, engaging all your senses, where with senses only we'll be sitting to read. But what senses we have to use, we should know, like vision, sound, writing. How does this help? Vision, whenever you see the textbook, now the books are coming in colors and all those things, either that also catches the eye, whereas not that one, the layout of the text in the book, I mean like where the flowcharts are given, where the diagrams are there, where some important points are there, like likewise, like some catchy things in the text that should form an image behind your brain. So you have to frame certain mind maps, certain pictures and some flow charts to remember very easily. That is a sight, importance of the visual application. And next is a sound. Sound, how does the sound play a role in the preparation? Yes, what you discuss with your colleagues or what you want to tell, I mean like among yourself, you can discuss the subject or you can present it to somebody who doesn't know it like that, or you can ask your seniors about something which you don't know. I mean like repeatedly stressing the same topic in different weights, inquiries and like discussions and all those things makes you remember very well. And then writing, always I've been stressing, read 200 pages but write at least 2 pages. So that is an equation, like writing. Write in a simple way which you can recollect by yourself. So writing also has got its role. Always make some small scratching notes at the side of the preparation. Whenever you read, make a point to scribble some notes by the side of it. And then critical reading, actively with all full involvement. Never read for somebody's sake or for some pressures. You read with your own senses all put together. And then the repeated study. As I told you, some revision tips. You have to revise certain things to remember them. And then condensing and simplifying subjects. That's what we have done in the QRS. You also do with your study material. That condenses and simplifies the subject. Grey's Anatomy coming into some 20 pages of your scribble notes is really awesome. So it is has got its own role in simplifying the subject. So make a small notes whenever you read. That will be more putting a more impact on your memory. So these are all the key home points. So you should have a goal. You have to thoroughly skim about the topics and associated reading with involvement of all your senses, and then critical reading with your good involvement in the subject. Read a small time doesn't matter, but how much involvement you show in the learning is more important. You read for 1 hour, you go watch a movie for other hour, no, it doesn't matter, it's equally good. I don't say that you stop everything entertainment, just sit with the book. No, you concentrate when you can concentrate. That grasps 90% of the subject. Then condense and simplify your subject and keep repeating that subject. Almost in a week, once or twice, you keep seeing what you scribbled, so that it will not allow you to forget what you read. And the next thing is like our book, QRS. I've been stressing quick review series for BDS. It is Dr. Jyotsnarao, it's me. And the advantages of this book are, as I've been showing you so many samples, so many ways of remembering the subjects, all is applied here. The questions of each subjects are arranged in the topic-wise manner. There is no need of confusion. Same topic you have in the book, you have it here. And at each chapter, we have divided the questions in such a way you can attempt any section very easily. And originality of the questions is maintained as it is given in that particular university along with the year by the side of it. And other flow charts, figures, everything is appropriately arranged. And in the section of the anatomy, we have given some diagrams to practice, because they're the common diagrams asked in the exam. There is a practice sheets also with dotted line diagrams are given. You can practice if you are very bad at diagrams also, that will help you to form some good curves. Okay, figures, flowcharts, tables, everything is arranged as per the requirement of the text. And the significances, it is a very schematically and precisely answered questions are laid out in the proper way for your good go through the examinations. And with this, I think I'm useful for you to attempt with your examinations. And all these tips might help you in a more better way to attempt your first professional examination. You are now a professional student entering your first year of professional life. So this carries with you throughout your 4 years, and it will help you to read the subject thoroughly. Now it is only three subjects, three differences, but when it comes to the final year, the application of the different subjects also starts. So every year has got a different technique to read. Reading is a common thing with everybody, but reading with some application, some mix and matches, and the tips to remember the subject are different with everyone. Even an average student with an appropriate orientation to the subject will gain very good marks, I say. So with this, I conclude my tips and tricks for you. I hope it was really helpful for you in coming examination. And remember all these things and try to apply as much as it is applicable to you. And thank you one and all for your patient listening. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rao. These were very useful tips for all our first year students here who are going to write the professional exams for the first time. So thank you very much. It's now time for Q&A. We have received many questions from the students here.
Yeah.
So, ma'am, I will first start with the question which maximum students have given to us here.
Sure.
And they want to know about neuroanatomy. How important is it for BDS students from the point of view of exams? And can you give few important topics in neuroanatomy?
Yeah, definitely. Because the nerve supply is a very, very important thing. If you, play toss with any nerve in the oral cavity, it leads to the paralyzing of that part also. Even when you are giving the anesthesia and all those things, this anatomy of the nerves, the supply of the nerves, especially the functioning. See, you have the sensory nerves and motor nerves. Sensory nerves to gain the senses and motor nerves to show the action. So all this anatomy of the nerves, of the nervous system, is very, very important, because tomorrow you're going to work on the patients. You should be very careful about the structures which passes in which region. Wherever you are working, you should be very, very thorough with the knowledge of the nerves. So that is what, in the very first chapter, when they start with this, they'll give you the cranial nerves and all those things, olfactory, all those nerves. And there is a saying, there's a lot of mnemonics are also available. There are small mnemonic books available. So they'll be useful for you to memorize this nerves, blood vessels, and all these things. I still remember in our anatomy class, my teacher was telling about, on occasion of tea parties, the attractive faces are girl visitors for the cranial nerves. Okay, olfactory, all these nerves will be memorized with this. Okay, so there are good mnemonics also available, and the knowledge of nerves is very, very important, Priyanka. So from the point of application in day-to-day practice also, they should be very, very careful in studying the nerves, because they endanger the things. When they work on the patient without the knowledge of this, there is going to be some cases of the certain paralyzed parts also.
Yes, ma'am, sure. So I think this is pretty clear for the students who have given this question now. Any important topics within neuroanatomy is also what they asked for.
Yeah, so definitely. The facial nerve branches. Okay, all the facial nerve branches and all the motor supplies to the tongue, to the oral cavity, even eyes. I mean, like you, when you put your fingers like this, all the applicate, I mean, like the supply of the nerves will be taught like this, you know. Like where all the different nerves will pass. So from the parotid gland, the facial nerve comes out and supplies the entire face. They just show these fingers to explain each branch of it. So all these things we can only deal when you deal with that particular chapter. So as okay. such, in this 1-2 seconds, we can't tell all those things. Mm-hmm. But there are certain criteria to study different nerves. Okay. Yeah, from the point of view of the glands, from the point of view of the structures where they are going, and supply of the each teeth, because when you are giving the anesthesia inside the oral cavity to numb the teeth when you are performing the procedures, there also the anatomy of the lingual nerve and then like mandibular nerve, all these are very, very important.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Thank you. So I'm moving to the next question now.
Yeah.
So students say that we could not attend any practical classes. So is there any advice you can give on how to compensate for those practical classes, how to prepare?
Same like this. We have to ask Elsie. We are not. You have to just support them with some video recordings.
Definitely.
Or dissections. Yeah, live dissections which are recorded can be portrayed to them. So the access is now only the net.
Yes.
And Elsevier is a platform.
Yes, so
I hand over this to
maybe
yeah,
we will answer them in the follow-up emailers,
yes,
that we will send. So we will give
yeah.
them some links and some tips to prepare
definitely
for that.
You have to
definitely. Sure, ma'am, thank
Fine.
You okay, so ma'am, next question we have is detailed note making is very time consuming. If we make notes, we have less time to remember. So what should we
yeah.
do for that?
No, don't make it detailed notes. Detailed notes is not required because everything is there in QRS. That is a detailed notes only. But I'm asking you to make a still smaller notes. See, QRS is having some 300-400 pages, means you make some 40 pages out of it. So per subject, at least a 10 page. Or if you can't make, don't worry. There are key points given. That is only the scribble notes. But only thing is, when you write in your own words, your own handwriting, that will have a more memory on your brain. That's only the reason I asked you to write. There is no need of writing. You just practice what is given in QRS key points. That's more than enough.
Thank you, ma'am. So next question, how many diagrams we should draw for a long answer and for a short answer?
See, appropriately, when they asked you, like nowadays, they are nicely dividing the long essay also. When they ask you some supply, some this thing, I mean, like pertaining to the nerve, this applied the part, then you better draw the diagrams. But anatomy is the diagram supported question answers will be like given the more marks. So always a diagram speaks more than your words. Even if you draw one diagram with the marking good, I mean like markings on it, like you label it properly, it speaks the entire text what you have written down. So that is how even the examiner can assess the students. So it's always better if you can put one small ray diagrams. You need not be an artist to draw a figure there. You just put the ray diagrams, I mean like pointing out what are the structures you want to show or what are the structures you have discussed down in your answer. So good thing is in the anatomy and the dental anatomy, better put the diagrams. Whereas physiology, biochemistry doesn't require so much. Only when they ask some cardiac cycles or some GIT, some part of it, if they ask, you can. There you can skip off, but not in the general anatomy and the oral anatomy. Try to put even the simple ray diagrams.
Okay, that's a very helpful tip, ma'am. So ma'am, the next question we have got is if you can give some idea about an ideal timetable of the day, how it looks like how many hours per day they should spend, what time, and basically a timetable for the breaking of the time.
What we have discussed now, weightage of the topics and all those things, if really they have that screenshot of that particular slide, it's more than enough. See, 10 topics are important. So how much time you want to take? 3 months. I told you simple tip in first year is 3 subjects, 3 months, as I told you. In that 3 months also, 10 topics are important. So 1 month allotted for that particular subject, 15 days you allot to this. So 1 day, how many hours you can read? Max, you can read 8 to 10 hours. I don't expect everybody to read 12, 13, 14 hours, I don't tell, because rest also is equally important. So as I told you, with involvement, if you're reading for 6 to 7 hours or the max before exam, max 8 hours, if you're reading, it's more than enough. And also then the topics, 10 topics, 15 days, you can complete easily. 1 day, one topic, how much time you want? 8 hours, one topic gets over. Actually, one topic you can read in 2 to 3 hours. Mm-hmm. And you can revise in the next 1 hour. Okay. Yes. So it's very simple. Like this particular first year is really first, second, third year, whatever it is. You have simple subjects and the time is good with you. So here there is no question of times. As I told you, 2 topics per day also you can read, including all the subjects. So how aram time you got for the exam preparation? It's not from the beginning. It is only last 3 months you are contributing. So daily 8 hours minimum you try to contribute. Definitely first class will come for you. There's no go in that. If you are thoroughly reading QRS also, daily if 10 to 15 pages you read also, you'll pass.
Yes. So I think everyone should make an effective timetable on how much time they have to study what topic. So they can just do the calculation accordingly.
Yeah. That's individual's choice. So you can't tie them and keep them for 8 hours there. So some people will be there, they'll read only 2-3 hours. They'll be happily watching all the movies, TVs, everything, but they'll gain the marks. Some fellow will be reading from the morning till evening, but still they can't put the answer. I have seen both the category of the students. So this cannot be generalized. It depends on their own capacities, Priyanka.
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, just 2 more questions we would take. First one I would want to ask is it a good time to start the preparation for NEET PG? The students are in their first year. So
see, NEET PG is nothing for you to start. You already started. See, what is PG exam? All these questions put in the MCQs format. Whatever we are reading for theory, when it is put for the MCQs, how will you answer? So you have to practice it once your exam gets over. My suggestion is don't play with both the platforms, because this is almost, it is a part of preparation going on. In case if you want to read, you can. See, MCQs, they form the Viva part. So keep some limited time. Say 2 hours, I want to do MCQs. Just take up all the NEET material, do those MCQs pertaining to that particular topic. See, nowadays you're getting a lot of NEET preparatory books with the topic wise and the questions are allotted according to topic. So it's really good. You can read the synopsis, what is given in that, and you can do MCQs. It is a part practical preparation for you, Viva preparation also. And don't stress too much, just allot a little time, 2 hours daily for this. Okay, it will be helpful for theory practical exam here and NEET exam there. So NEET is nothing different from what you are reading. And also this is not the, I mean, like, they are not entitled for any NEET exam. They need not worry about the NEET exam preparation now. It is only for final years who bother about the NEET exam. For first years, no exam except their own exam. Fine.
Yes. Yes. So with this, ma'am, I'll just ask one last question and before we wrap up the session today. Okay. So the students want to know some quick and easy tips to study biochemistry since they feel it is very difficult to remember and understand.
Tips in the sense there is no shortcut routes and there is no, I mean, like, magic to read the biochemistry. Only thing is you can, that's what I told you, know, when you're reading the carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, no, the chapters are given separately. And the chemistry we'll read somewhere and metabolism we'll read end of the text. So what you can do is whenever you are reading the chemistry of this, go to the metabolism of the same in the next following chapters. So you need not read, I mean, like, usually what happens, we read chemistry first in the beginning chapters of chemistry of carbohydrates separately, proteins, lipids separately. But what I felt is, like, when you read the chemistry of this, when you read the metabolism also, hand in hand, it goes quickly and you'll understand better. And only thing is, make the flow charts. Usually all the cycles, all the metabolic cycles are given in the ray diagram format only, or the flow charts. So you have to practice and memorize. Biochemistry is just like numericals only. That is, I mean, like cycle, you can't break anywhere. It is a designed metabolisms. So you have to remember all those products and all those things which comes in the as a byproduct of the reactions. So those things, there is no go. Only thing is, you club these two sections and read, it will be easy. And you have to memorize. You keep on repeating them, because what they'll ask, carbohydrate and glycolysis and the Krebs cycle and all those things. What you can do with that? Only you have to put that cycle daily as the morning you get up. You just have to look at those and memorize it. That's all. Or in the third onwards, you start writing that cycle. Automatically you remember that. That's the only tip I can tell, because there is nothing, no magic to condense the subject.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
So, ma'am, there are more questions, but because we are already overshoot the time, we have already overshoot the time. So, I would like send the questions to you on email,
yeah,
and
definitely.
Then
we'll
you can answer.
All of them. Yeah.
Yes. So, we will answer all the remaining questions to the participants through an email, maybe in a few days. So, with this, Dr. Rao, any parting notes you would like to say?
All the best for their exams. We have already loaded them with a lot of tips. Now only we can wish for their good success. So all the best for all the participants, whoever are attempting the first BDS exams. Do well in your exams. And maybe these tips will helpful for you till your final year exams.
Yes, I'm very
Thank
sure
you.
These tips will be useful for them. So just a note for the participants here, a recording of this session and the certificate of participation will be sent to you over the email along with the answers to the remaining questions that you have asked. Thank you once again for giving us your time today. Thank you, everyone.